This was my second train ride of the night. The way it started didn't promise anything better than the last one. Freezing wind tearing at my face like sandpaper and razors. Ice hard and slick under my hands and feet. Somewhere in the background, the wail of sirens. The city howling after me.
Alright, so now we're entering the next chapter. And it starts off with Max hitching a ride on the train. He says it's second train ride of the night. He's referring to when he was in the train station on his way to Alex, which is pretty crazy to realize that the entire night he went from train station to the hotel blowing up, to trying to chase down Vinny Gogniti through like three different buildings. It's a long night, right? This is a long night. And he says the way that it started didn't promise anything better than the last one. So when he had his last train ride, it ended up with his friend dying. Here, he's like, this is another train ride, and I don't see it going any better than the last one, so it's probably going to be something worse than my friend dying. Freezing wind tearing at his face like sandpaper and razors. It's a good way to explain how snow is very dangerous. The death around him, the symbolic death through snow, is tearing at his face, the thing, his image, the thing that we use to identify him as. It's tearing away like sandpaper and razors. So death around him is tearing away at his image of his humanity. Ice hard and slick under my hands and feet. He's slipping. He's not sure if he's going to be able to hold on to the train. It's a sense of uncertainty. And also how the world under him is this blur of movement that is also kind of slipping under him. The world is slipping away from him. And somewhere in the background, the wail of sirens, the city howling after him. In Greek mythology, we have sirens, and these are creatures that will sing to you to lead you to your demise. Something beautiful, an alluring trap that brings you to your death, your doom. So the sirens are wailing in the background as the city is howling after him. The city is chasing him rather than him being allured by the sirens. So it's another way of saying the second that the sirens reach him, he's doomed, right? But they're after him, they're in the background, they're still distant. So his doom is distant, but it's coming near. And the city howling after him is in relation to the wolf. The wolf is going to be approaching soon. We're going to meet Fenrir. And perhaps we can say that Max is also the wolf serpent. The Jungmugbugun, I can't pronounce that one. The poisonous serpent that's under Yggdrasil, that's eating away at the roots. Maybe he is the one that is that very thing, you know, or maybe there's something more powerful than he is that can be that thing.
New York sped by and fast forward, dark rooftop water towers and a dead forest of antennas and chimneys, all a blur.
When he says New York sped by on the fast forward, the whole world in front of him is just blurring by. He can't recognize it, it's chaotic. There's a lot of chaos going on, a lot of death around him from the snow. The lights are under him, the light is below him, and it's a tiny light. Small, tiny lights coming from the train. So the train is, in a way, you can imagine this being similar to, you know how, like, in Greek mythology, there's, like, a boatman, Charon? I think it's Charon or Charon? Charon, whatever his name is. But the boatman brings you to Hades. Now, Max is taking a train. First, he went to the underworld, then he came out. He went upwards towards a hotel, which could be kind of like a tiny tower. A tiny tower made by the mafia. That one's destroyed, right? It blew up. And then we ended up going on a train to another destination, another area. I have no idea where Vinny's trying to get to. He's just trying to get away from him. And he's insane enough to jump on all these trains to get out. Dark rooftop water towers and a dead forest of antennas and chimneys, all a blur. So when they say dead forest of antennas and chimney, I really like that imagery, because antennas and chimneys, they look like logs, like stumps, and they look like branches, but no leaves, no life. So it's dead, right? So dead forest around him. He's entering a forest, if anything. And if there's a Norse mythology or Germanic mythology story that involves a forest, we're entering an area with, you know, whatever you want to call them, wood elves or something. I'm pretty sure, like, wood elves are like a forest, like a magic forest is trying to be implied here. I'm just not sure exactly what forest it could be. But the second he says forest, it's a mixture of modernism, modernity is what they call it, and then naturalism. So when it comes to something like this story, noir, it's a rejection of romanticism. So it's bringing in this gothic element by having a beautiful forest imagery combined with death. So horrific and creepy, but also in a modern sense, in an urban setting.
When the train he was riding slowed down, Gagnidi made his move.
Aw, damn, he's bleeding. Somebody ran a train on him. I could do that if I felt like it. Burger joint!
It's raining, Max! Hallelujah, it's raining pain!
You saw me, you goddamn son of a bitch, you saw me.
Now we're on the rooftop, and we're gonna go towards Vinny Gagnidi. Oh, where am I supposed to go? Feels like it's this way.
I haven't seen pipes like this since that sting operation in the Mushroom Kingdom.
Mario Pain, whee! Get the shotgun guy first. Oh, ready to go. I see you. Let's go! Oh, it wasn't even a shotgun, it was a normal Beretta. Standing on the rooftops waiting to what? Hey, is there a little bit closer to heaven? Yeah, I'm really tall up here on the tower, aren't I? Go across, don't fall down. Oh, blood trail. Oh. Where are they? They're stuck. I got you now. Got me on the reload. Dude, I haven't been shot at all.
The stars have aligned.
Speaking of Mario, this game does have a lot of platforming. I think it was inspired by Duke Nukem, which was sort of inspired by, you know, Mario.
NYPD, you
unlock. Hell, mate.
Drop your weapon and lie down.
I think he's trying to communicate.
Drop your weapon and lie face down.
I bet you say that to all the boys.
It's Pain! He's coming down the stairs! Shoot the bastard!
Okay, boss, you got it.
No problem.
Cuts to Max Payne rolling down the stairs.
Should I throw a grenade down there?
What the hell?
How the hell did he dodge the blast? I'm not getting shot, they're not getting hit by my grenades. Our pets' heads are falling off!
Got a pump. Oh! Dude, what's going on? I've literally been shot by nobody. I'm in the zone today. Get in the zone! Max Payne zone! Aw, they're making finger paints. We're on the first floor, still following the blood trail. Vinny Gagnini's really running out, isn't he? Oh, Jesus. My first bullet that hit me.
I shall keep this bullet under my flesh as a memento.
Oh my goodness. That's coming. Alright, he's down. Not just this bastard. Alright, it's not bad. Oh, another person, where is he?
Is he peeing on me from above the roof?
I saw the flash. Oh. Coming from that little doorway.
This is really one of those few games where the shotgun could work more than 3 feet away. Same with the Halo, the first one.
And he's down too. Should we use the Ingrams? Playing basketball over here. This looks like the area in Spider-Man 2. The very, very old one from the PlayStation 1 era, which I really want to play in the playthrough, but oh boy, howdy, is it difficult to get a PlayStation game working. Also, I'm kind of lazy to get a, what do you call those things, those little adapters for the TV. I'm more comfortable with PC games, thank you very much.
Stop it, stop it! Vinny Gagnini sucks as a shooter! A child could beat him!
What does it say? Cranky Anchors? Valkyr, Valkyr, Valkyr. V, V, V. Vinny, Vinny, Vici. Look, I hate saying this all the time, but this is totally a Silent Hill area. This is like that area in the first Silent Hill game. Come on. How do you not see the resemblance? Max is like, I've been holding it forever. I haven't pissed in 3 days. Ever since my family died, I haven't taken a shit or a piss. This must explain my feces fascination.
Shouldn't construction areas on rooftops have porta-johns where I can get some painkillers?
Oh god. Where is that coming from? Oh, maybe up here? Oh, it's that guy over there. Let's see if this works. No, he's this one instead. Alright, that works. Voice of the Angels. I could swear that actually means something in the game.
The babe on the poster looks a bit like Max's wife.
Deactivate this up here, dude. So that guy is coming up here. That would be funny if Max is like following his blood trail the whole time, and it just cuts to like a bathroom that has like some kind of crackhead woman who's like on her period.
She's just shitting blood into the sink.
I'm sorry for being vulgar. No, that was uncalled for.
I'm a disgusting human being and I apologize.
Get him!
Oh my goodness. Oh no, where are they coming from? Oh. I'll allow it. Oh my god! Ah, more people coming! At least let my health go all the way down again. At least wait till the pills kick in. I got it. Okay, I don't know if I should accept this, but... YOLO. Gotta Ingram these bad boys. Here we go. America's Avenger for the payback time. I love these kinds of like American flags with like guns on it. Europeans really find that fascinating.
Must be Second Amendment envy.
This Captain Baseball Bat Boy, he's back. He's mean and he's got a bat.
He's got a yummy baseball bat shaped cock.
I'm sorry, that was uncalled for again. Oh geez, today is an off day, isn't it? Oh, is this thing open? Looks like it's supposed to. What's up in these things then? When you come through the skyline like a big pizza pie line, that's some more, right? Oh my god, I got like really horribly damaged.
It feels like somebody was trading money for Nickelodeon slime.
Mmm, delicious green slime. I like how it's like a weird tube. The money. The green next to green. Green plus green equals? I'm not really sure. Green plus green equals bean?
Alright, Dan Schneider, show yourself, you foot-ogling scumbag.
Let's blow this up.
Well, I've done all I can do.
A much-needed painkiller.
Why does every stairs have a guy throwing a grenade down it?
Please, God, don't have the grenade explode on me. Okay. I'm safe. Oh, where is that coming from?
The old stand behind you and shoot at you trick. Works every time. I'm not in a good condition.
This is like the exact opposite of what was going on before.
Oh, is this an area where I can heal? Please let there be drugs somewhere around here. Come on, it's an apartment. There's bound to be drugs. Sink with brown water, that's close, but not enough. The bathroom. They'll need a what? A forklift, oh.
Well, in the meantime, let's watch some TV.
Max Payne has nowhere left to go. We are very close to capturing him. You'll get a full statement then. Right now, I've got better things to do, ma'am.
That was Deputy Chief Jim Bravura from the NYPD with no further comment at this time.
Apart from his suspicious food habits, I figured Bravura to be one of the good guys. Fate had just dropped us on different sides in this. But when it came to capturing me, he was way out of his league. I had already ditched the cops a couple of rooftops back. For now.
This part's not too significant. Jim Bavora talking about how Max Payne is going to be captured, we're going to get him for sure, you'll get a full statement later, and they're really busy. But Jim Bavora doesn't really do much, which is pretty funny. So far he still hasn't done anything, but somehow he has something better to do. And when Max says, apart from his suspicious food habits, I figured Bavora to be one of the good guys. When he says suspicious food habits, he sees Bavora as like a fat guy. So this could be some kind of nod towards how cops are usually shown as fat during the 90s. And they're like eating too many donuts and they're just eating like a pig, you know, like how cops are pigs. And so to have horrible food habits means you're not necessarily a good guy, you're just on the side of the law. Meaning you're not a moral bastion who everybody is supposed to look up to. And then when he says fate had just dropped us on different sides in this, he's saying that Max is not a good guy, and Jim Bavura is not really a good guy. Neither one of them is the good hero. It's just indirectly telling you, both of us are technically some kind of anti-hero, we're not really meant to be moral bastions, and you're not really supposed to copy us. But when it came to capturing me, he was way out of his league. I had already ditched the cops a couple rooftops back, meaning Jim Bavura has no idea where Max Payne is, and he has to kind of bullshit his way through an interview, and before any answers can actually be given, he's like, don't worry, we got it under control, but they really don't because Max is nowhere to be found in the places they're looking for, and a couple rooftops away. That's just telling you the level that you are in. You're already a couple rooftops away from where you began when you jumped off the train in the first place. And he says, for now, and that's kind of trying to foreshadow that he does get captured in the end. You know, spoilers on the 20-year-old game, but yeah, he gets captured in the end, which is shown in the beginning of the goddamn game. Also in my video thumbnails. Alright, it's like a million people outside. Let's get them! Yeah. There's only one. Oh, cheese and crackers. Oh, goddammit! Oh, how did I dodge that? That was obviously a glitch. How did I survive that explosion? Go back up there, rewind that clip. It was in the explosion. There's a guy. He dropped dead like a sack of potatoes.
Oh god!
Someone's flushing the toilet while I'm fighting these guys. Alright. Got nicked by a little pebble. I never knew how hard this mission was. And we still got a boss battle coming up too. Yay.
You'd think a shotgun would be able to blast through some wood.
Oh, there's a guy. He's doing the chimichanga cha-cha. He knows I'm coming. And he's going. Oh, you like grenades. Well, I got nothing there. Probably killed like two cockroaches. I hope he doesn't have a grenade. Oh my god!
That's it!
How about taste your own medicine, bitch boy?
I've got something for you, Voodoo.
Yeah, how do you like that? Dirty son of a bitch. Throw grenades at me, will ya?
Oh no.
It's Vinny. Vinny the Winnie.
Open, goddammit!
Open the freaking door.
Pain! I'll kill you, you lousy freaking
cunt! Alright. Vinny seems to be alone. And I was wrong. Where is health? Oh, yeah. The environment did not help me. Alright, there's a guy somewhere. Where is he? There he is. Got him. One more guy. Oh, goodness. This is so tense. I can't jump from there. I guess I can jump from here. Tell me you saw that dead ass shot.
Ah!
Limp away, Max. Does this explode? Die. Oh goodness, I have no health. This is intense. This is just like campaign because it's intense. I hope it's the last of his goons. How's this gonna end? Can I actually defeat these guys? There's like a million guys more. Get him on the reload. My balls are in my throat. And this bastard has dual Ingrams. Oh, my hands are shaking.
Oh my god. Vinny. No, he's got a Desert Eagle.
Oh goodness. Okay. Grenade him.
Oh goodness.
He got stunned by the grenade. Die already! Why won't you die? Okay, last ditch effort.
Hi!
Finally!
Gogniti ran out of steam in a dead end alley with steam boiling out of the sewer grates like all the fires of hell were burning high beneath us. It was shakedown time.
Alright, I gotta calm down after that intense boss battle with no health. So he says Gogniti ran out of steam in a dead-end alley with steam boiling out of the sewer grates like all the fires of hell are burning high beneath us. Right now, Max feels like he is in what is essentially Ragnarok. The snow is falling, death, destruction, desolation, all that. Darkness. Now he has the fires of hell below them boiling up water, steam. So steam, again, is a very alchemical way of handling things. Steam is magical. It's not the same as like water plus heat makes air. In this kind of story, steam is a purification process. So there's purification happening below them within the fires of hell. Or steam, like a purity is wafting upwards away from hell. And when he says that he ran out of steam, meaning he ran out of purity, he's now in dead end alley. Alright, dead end alley. He is dying. And his body's bleeding out. He's about to die. And now Vinny is in this hell where a cop, undercover cop, is pretty much killing him. You know, he's suffering, he's not dead yet, but he now has to get shucked down. And when he gets shaken down, that's like the worst thing to happen for somebody like Vinny, because then he has to admit to all of his sins.
Where's Lupino?
Screw you!
Bad start, Vinny.
Police brutality!
I rate pretty high on that.
You can't just hurt me in cold blood?
Just keep telling yourself that. Listen good, Candyman. I'm not gonna be anybody's fall guy. I wanna know where your boss is hiding.
I love this part. So you ask him, where's Lupino? He's like, nah, I'm not gonna say anything. And he's like, well, that's a bad start. I'm gonna hurt you. It's gonna be way worse, and you're gonna wish you're dead. And Vinny, he's like, oh no, the police guy's brutalizing me. And he's like, look, not only am I really good at that, it doesn't even matter. Because I'm not even really police anymore. And this is all my own. This is personal. And Vinny's like, oh fuck, I can't deal with this shit. So then when he says, listen good, Candyman, he's saying, listen, you drug dealer. Candyman, drug dealer, it's like a... Yeah. Give me the candy balls. And when he says, I'm not gonna be anybody's fall guy, He means I'm not going to be someone's scapegoat. I'm not going to be the one that you get to get away with because you sacrificed me instead. So he's like, I'm not someone's bitch. You're my bitch now. And that's fucking great. I love that in Max Payne. He does not take shit from anybody. He is giving the shit. He's flinging the shit. And he says, I don't want to know where your boss is hiding right now. You're going to tell me. And Vinny, he's suffering right now. You know, he has a fear, two things, either dying or wishing he was dead once this psychopath, this absolute berserk savage. Like when Lupino gets his hands on him after finding out that he was told on. So all that Vinny can really hope for is that Max is going to kill Lupino.
There was no glory in this. I hadn't asked for this crap. Trouble had come to me in big dark swarms. The good and the just were like gold dust in the city. I had no illusions. I was not one of them. I was no hero. Just me and the gun and the crook. My options had decreased to a singular course.
Oh, goodness. Just hearing that part gave me chills. Okay, I got calmed down. So when he says there's no glory in this, he's like, I'm not doing this for something that's a gain, no reward. There is no hero's journey where there's gold at the end of the rainbow. There's no gold at the end of the journey. It's just another form of gold. You know, there's no glory, but there's some kind of reward that I can kind of assume there is, and that's revenge. And that's why revenge stories are, they're usually seen as like kind of flat or flaccid, not really impressive. But this kind of revenge story, it is alchemical, it is downright cosmic, you know, like with a Lovecraftian cosmicism, and it has so much existentialism from this particular moment here. I'm not doing my actions because I think I'm going to get rewarded with glory. I'm doing my actions just because I want to. I want to, and it's out of pure frustration and pure anger, pure wrath, and pure pain. And when he says, I hadn't asked for this crap. He's like, I didn't really want this to happen. I didn't want to go off and kill a child predator. I didn't want to go off and kill some kind of savage, you know, Neanderthal like Jack Lupino. I just wanted to live a normal life as a, you know, protector of the law. And, you know, as a family man with a wife and kid. And he says, trouble had come to me in big dark swarms. It's like a locust. It's like the plagues of Egypt. You know, big dark swarms of crackheads pretty much came into his house. And dark, when he says dark, he means evil, of chaos, of nothingness, of absolute randomness. And then he says, the good and the just were like gold dust in the city. I had no illusions. I was not one of them. I was no hero. He's saying that there is good in the city, and there is just, like justice, but it is very rare. It's a rare thing that just flows away out of your reach. And it's constantly going away with the wind. You know it's there somewhere, but you just can't really see it. Gold dust has a slang. It means like something that is very precious to everybody. Everybody wants it, but it's so rare because everybody wants it. Because, you know, enlightenment. And that does make sense for this kind of symbolism. Good and just is very much like gold dust. Because gold is another metallic symbolism for enlightenment, light, spiritual fire, stuff like that. The sun. And when he says good and just, that is what the sun and spiritual fire and enlightenment is all about. The good and the just. The justified, the logical, the enlightened, all that jazz. And then when he says I'm with no hero, this is just refining what he said previously when he's watching the news report. He's saying, I'm not the hero here. And it's kind of hard to say Max is a hero when he's constantly telling us himself, I am not a hero. I am very clearly an anti-hero, or at the very least an anti-villain. And anyway, he says, just me and the gun and the crook. He's saying there's only three things that even matter in this life here, in this very moment. And my options had been decreased to a singular course. Only one thing I can do now, just kill people, because it's me, the gun, and the crook. I am the judge, jury, executioner, you know, the judge dread of it all. And I have my weapon, my technology to do it so. And I have the crook, the evil one who has wronged me. And that's all that he has now. And that's what his life's become. Just him killing people with guns. And that's what the whole game is about. And that's a really chilling moment because just imagine your life reduced to that kind of, you know, trifecta. What do you call it? Trilogy.
I'll tell you. Just don't hurt me no more. Lupino's at Ragnarok, the nightclub. Book me. Take me in the home into the freaking jail. Just don't hurt me.
Your rites will be read at your funeral.
Oh, jeez. That's a badass moment. So he clicks the gun, like the hammer back, and then he's like, "Look, I'm gonna shoot the crap out of you." And he's like, all right, I'll tell you. Just don't hurt me, because he's already hurting enough as it is. He's already suffering. And Vinny Gogniti seems to be somebody who can't really take a hit, but he can really dish it out, because they said that he is a sadist, but he's not really a masochist. So he really hates being hurt. He's a wimp from that. But he wants to dish it out to look tough, but, you know, deep inside, he's really not tough at all. He's kind of like a nerd who got wrapped up into mafia stuff, which is great to be an informant, because he cracks like an egg under pressure. And when he says, "Book me, haul me, take me away, just don't hurt me," he's like, "Look, just take me to jail. I just don't want to be harmed by you," okay? He doesn't want to be harmed by Max himself, because he can see the ferocity in his eyes of like, "I am not even a human anymore. I'm actually a beast in the human skin, and I will make you suffer." And he's like, "Oh, fuck. All right, I'll tell you where he is. He's at the Ragnarok nightclub." And this is like one of the best parts in the whole game, the Ragnarok nightclub, because this is where Ragnarok begins. And Ragnarok is the moment where, in Norse mythology, we have the end of the world. So the end of the world begins here, and this is where we meet Jack Lupino, who is, in fact, Fenrir, the wolf, which he will tell us himself once we get to that part. And then Max says, "Your rites will be read at your funeral," meaning you're gonna die, and you're gonna get rites the second you die. So you don't deserve rites when you're alive, because you're such a scumbag. Instead, you're gonna get your rites read to you once you're dead. And that doesn't happen. You know, in the second game, we don't actually get Vinny Gogniti dead. He actually survives the whole thing. And I'm not sure if that's really a good thing or a bad thing. It exists, it's there, but I personally don't have an opinion on whether or not that was the right thing to do. I think it's more where Max wants him to die, because that's how much he hates this guy. Because of all the things he read about him, all the trouble he's caused, all the things that he did, makes him run across the whole city and jump over trains and everything like that. You know, he's like, "I hope you die." That's pretty much what it's all about. And he drops his gun, meaning, "I'm not even gonna shoot you. I'm gonna let the world handle your nonsense." And that's the end of that chapter.